So the different activities which divided on the basis of a production. So these facilities, these activities, they are generally all of these services and the facilities, they put together constitutes the infrastructure of an economy. Infrastructure. Now, question arises here, that what is the infrastructure? For economic growth and development, it is essential to expand and develop the infrastructure of the economy. A sound infrastructure contributes to the economic development by increasing the productivity of the factors of production and by improving the quality of life of its people. Transport carries the men and materials from one place to another. Similarly, the means of communication, post, telegraph, telecommunication services, etc., help to bring buyers and sellers together. Clear? So the infrastructure means the foundation which can be taken as a basis to all activities in the economy, whether related to agriculture or industry or even trade. It is defined as the physical framework of economy. It is supporting the structure that provides the different kinds of activities in the main areas of production, such as agriculture production, industrial production, trade and commerce. Clear? So infrastructure, what is it generally means? It is the foundation which can be taken as a basis to all activities in the economy, whether related to the agriculture or industry. For example, as the most number of industries are developed in such areas where the means of transport are developed, markets are available. Clear? In such area where the health institutes are available at a low cost, or the education institutes are there for the workers. So all these, where these are present in such areas, the industrialists, they are invest their money and the growth of the industries. It is just as the possible that the raw material is far away from the production units. Produced goods are taken to the markets with the help of the transport. Similarly, as a power is also needed in the most of economic activities. We cannot do without the facilities like power, communication, health, education, etc. Unhealthy and illiterate people produce less than the healthy and educated people. So infrastructure contributes to economic development and also improves the quality of life. Good infrastructure increases the production. It contributes in an increase in production, and good infrastructure, it decreases the risk of spreading epidemics and controls the diseases when it spread. With the help of the efficient and fast communication, we try to protect our people. So there's one example, the word bird flu. When the bird flu, it spreads. Under such circumstances, the telecommunication services to which the information transmitted to the different parts of the world, to which they are spread, the spread of a bird flu, it can be as restricted. So the infrastructure is necessary for the growth of economy, for development of economy. I'm repeating again, the infrastructure has contributes in economic development and also improves the quality of the life. Good infrastructure decreases the risk of spreading the such number of a disease which are spreading as more hurriedly. Clear? Now the next is the increasing importance of the tertiary sector in production. increasing importance of tertiary sector in production, tertiary sector in production in India. During the last 4 decades, tertiary sector has emerged the largest producing sector in the sense of a job opportunities. More job opportunities generated by the tertiary sector comparatively to primary and the secondary sectors. Primary and secondary sectors. So vigorous growth with strong macroeconomic fundamentals has characterized the development in the Indian economy in 2006-07. So there are some of the genuine concerns on the inflation front. Inflation front. Yes, it affects the supply. Supply is a lesser comparatively the demand under such circumstances the hike in prices recorded. For example, during the rainy season, there is basically as a shortage of a vegetables, onion. So such type of a goods, these their prices there, there is a hike comes in their prices. Yes, Raghav. So there are the several reasons for the importance of a tertiary sector or a service sector. India is a developing country. A developing country needs the basic services like as a health, education, communication, transport, bank, insurance, administrative offices, etc. So the development of a primary and a secondary sectors, primary and secondary sectors also necessitates the development of a services such as the transport, trade, banking, insurance, finance, etc. With the rise in the level of the income and standard of living of the people, demand for better services like private schools, private hospitals, services based on information and communication technology, tourism, restaurants, hotels, other amenities and facilities of the society, they increase day by day. The importance of infrastructure for sustained economic development is well recognized. High transaction cost arising from the inadequate and inefficient infrastructure can prevent the economy from realizing its full growth potential regardless of progress on other fronts. Physical infrastructure covering the transport, power and communication through the backward and forward linkages facilitates the growth social infrastructure including the water supply, sanitation, sewage disposal, and education and health, which are in the nature of the primary services, has a direct impact on the life of the people, which improving as the life of the people, the living standard of that particular society, it improve where the basic infrastructure provided by the government, because industrialists, they invest in their money and set up the new industrial units. Such industrial units makes possibilities of a more supply of goods through which the prices of goods controlled, inflation controlled. In the other side, such industries, they provided as a job opportunities to the people. A large number of a job opportunities to the people. With growth of a population, the other kind of services, they are also starts to develop. For example, as a marketing, shopping complexes, private hospitals, schools, professional training, etc. Such kind of the facilities, they are also improving where the basic infrastructure provided by the government. If that question has coming in your mind, as a present, the most number of roads, these are built by the private companies, not by the government. There is the reason behind this is the toll plaza. My concern is with the toll plazas. basically as a private companies, they take as the, they sign as a contract with the government. After constructing as the highways, national highways, they are collecting the taxes, toll tax for a certain period of time, for 4, 5, 10 years. Afterwards, the such the collection of a toll tax, it will be as a handled by the government in a later stage, because the government not having as a fund, there is a scarcity of a fund, and such funds, scarcity of a funds, it sorted out to the private companies, which pass their tenders and construct, they built as the roads, and on the basis of the construction, they collected the toll tax for a certain period of time. Afterwards, the government, it take over their rights in their hands. Clear? So generating income to the nation. Next is the, where are the most of the people employed in economy? Most of the people, as we read in our previous class, most number of people, they are employed in a primary sector. 60% of our job opportunities directly and indirectly provided by the primary sector. So there has been a change in the share of the three sectors in GDP, but a similar change is not visible with the regard to employment. It means as a more number of job opportunities provided by the primary sector, and a 40% of job opportunities generated by the secondary and the tertiary sector. But in contribution, the contribution of these sectors in economy of the country, as that 20% primary sector and 80% by the secondary and the tertiary sector, they directly contributes in economy. Clear? So that is as the opposite work. Basically, as the primary sector which generates as a job opportunity, such kind of a job opportunities are a disguised unemployed. So the primary sector continues to be the largest employer. When an economy grows, it offers more and varied employment opportunities. The people tend to shake off their traditional dependence on agriculture. They run out to cities and urban areas in search of jobs in the significance of different sectors in the employment situation of the country changes. In the Indian economy, the same similar changes have been in evident. The rate of change has been slow. Around the last 70 years of the independence, when the India got the independence in 1947, at that time, a large section, more than 70% of the people directly and indirectly dependent on a primary sector and their allied activities. So all those activities, farming, forestry, fishing, in such kind of activities, directly and indirectly, they dependent on it for the earning of their livelihoods. Some of them, they run out to the cities and the urban areas in search of the jobs in the secondary and tertiary sectors of the economy. As a result, the relative significance of different sectors in the employment situation of the country changes. People who are employed and people who employ, as well as people who are self-employed, are all treated as the workers and known as the workforce. I'm repeating again, as the people who employ and people who employ, as well as people who are self-employed, are all treated as workers, called workforce. In the composition of the unemployed, a large number of people are basically the educated unemployed. As compared to the educational professional degrees or the qualification, they are not getting the jobs. They constitute as a very large section in our economy. In our economy. in an economy. So they work on the shop or as the landless laborers or construction workers in cities. There is a variety of the ways in which the employment data is presented. So one of the classification as a sectoral and the other occupational classification of sectors, the role or the number of people which employed in these sectors. Basically, the number of people which are unemployed in our country, these are due to the high growth of a population and as compared to the population growth, the number of job opportunities are not increasing. That's why as a disguised unemployed are existing in society. Disguised unemployed means it is a situation in which more people are employed in an activity. Then the required ones. So as compared to the demand, when the more people are employed in the working sites is known as the disguised unemployment. The removal of such extra workforce has not influenced the production. For example, 1 acre of land is there which require only as 2 persons throughout the year for the production of crops. But due to the lack of job opportunities, the other family members, they are also engaged. They are also dependent on same agriculture fields. If we remove such extra workforce, their dependence on land, that particular 1 acre of land, then what will be happen? Production, it will not influence. The inclusion of more number of workforce, they can't increase as production because land sources are limited. Soil is the same, production tenure is the same, then production, it will be as a same. It may be as a decrease, but it can't be as an increase because earlier, whatever the inputs, newer agriculture inputs used for the production, same as such use in a presence. So removal of extra workforce not influence the production in agriculture fields. The people who are actually engaged in such an activities appear to be employed but not fully employed. It is a situation in which more persons are working on a piece of land than are required. If a few of these persons are removed from the land, this would not adversely affect the agricultural growth, agricultural output. When more people are employed in a job than actually required, they are called as disguised unemployed. Disguised unemployment is a situation in which more people are employed as compared to their demand. The removal of the inclusion and exclusion of extra workforce in a working site not influence the production. And this disguised unemployment, it's generally only lies in a primary sector. The farmer which has having as 2 acres of land, their complete family dependent on that particular agriculture field. They are not hiring any of extra workforce, but complete of a family dependent on that particular agriculture field. So that family which dependent on a land resource, they are considered as disguised unemployed. If a part of the labor force is withdrawn and the total production remains the same, this withdrawal of labor will be known as the disguised unemployed labor. Clear? Till there, any questions? Yes. we solve the problem of disguised unemployed? What are the measures through which we can remove the disguised unemployment in the agricultural sector? First, loans should be provided to the small farmers by the government or the banks to have more irrigation facilities like wells and tube wells in order to enable them to grow the second crop. Clear? Dilpreet Singh, any problem? Second one, as a banks, it should provide the agriculture credit to the farmers for farming to improve the farming as compared to the subsistence. They have to work for the commercial farming. Third one, health services should be improved in rural areas by opening the dispensaries and hospitals through which a large number of people, they will be employed in such dispensaries and hospitals. Fourth, tourism, regional craft, cottage industries, information technology should be encouraged by the government to create more employment opportunities in rural areas. Fifth one, new dams and canals, it should be constructed. This will lead to more employment in the agricultural sector. Transportation and storage facilities must be improved to provide the productive employment to not only the farmers but also others to service like transport and trade also. Seventh, to set up agro-based industries, increase the more number of units related with the agro-based industries. It should be as increase in localities through which as more job opportunities will generate than that extra workforce which engaged in a primary sector, it will move towards such agro-based industries. And for the removal of such disguised unemployed, government it initiated the MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. It assured the 100 days of job opportunities to the villagers. 100 days of job opportunities to villagers. If panchayat unable to provide as a job opportunities, then there is a provision of a unemployment allowance for the survival of a workforce. This is as the provision under the MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Clear? So any questions? So how to create as a more employment? Yes, Raghav Arora. So how to create as a more employment? So existence of infrastructure facilities and services in itself is a source of the employment. These services improve the economic environment. They provide as a conditions available for carrying out the economic activities. Entrepreneurs are started to set up the more industrial units by the improved conditions and sound infrastructure facilities provided by the government. They come forward to undertake more production and manufacturing activities. The employment opportunities are generated in the country. India is a responsibility of the government. And India as a developing country, it also requires as a more industrial growth and the growth of a services as compared to the primary sector. There is always a good demand for the goods and services. There is a shortage of a capital in the country. So for this, the foreign investors want to invest in India, but they feel discouraged due to the lack of infrastructural facilities. To increase such kind of investment by the foreigners, government, it opted the liberal policies. It opted as the liberal policies, the liberalization and the concept of a globalization in the 1990s, through which the other countries of the world, they encourage, they moving towards India for the investing money in a secondary sector, clear? For the growth of a secondary sector. So by providing as an infrastructure facilities, we can attract a direct foreign investment, which will generate the employment opportunities also. Better infrastructure facilities like better roads, uninterrupted power supply, countrywide communication system, etc., can promote the expansion of trade within the country as well as the outside the country, which ultimately enhance the opportunities of employment. We know that there is the underemployment in agricultural sector. There are also the farmers who held the small agriculture fields, which have no irrigation facilities, assured irrigation facilities. So if the government comes to their help or banks provide the loans for constructing wells for irrigation, they will be able to irrigate the land and take a second crop or a third crop throughout the year. Certain number of areas are there where the three crops are produced in a more than 60% of agriculture fields. Assam, Meghalaya, and Tamil Nadu. Those areas where the assured irrigation facilities are available. Not due to the rivers, it's due to the monsoons. In Assam, there are three crops of rice are possible to produce. Parts of Assam. Three crops of rice. But in parts of Punjab, only one crop of rice is only possible during summers only. Clear?